Hi everyone, in this framer tutorial, we're going to create these great stick scroll animations with icons. You can find a link to the framer file in the description below if you like to remix and practice. So let's get started. As you see, I've only created the top part beforehand to spend more time on the parts that I need to demonstrate. First, we're going to create our section components, elements and structure, starting with the title frame. So I'll create a frame and name it section title and carry it to the desktop breakpoint under the top part stack. Now we can change section title frame's properties and create its inner elements before duplicating it. First, I'll make its position type sticky at right hand sidebar, and we need it to have some top space. I'll enter 150 for its top value, and under size, I'm going to make its width 400. And its height 245. We only need a gradient at the bottom as background for the inner frames of our sections. To keep it same in the both left and right parts of the section regardless of their heights, I'll create a separate frame just for the background. But first, I'll remove the section title's background under the styles. Then I will create a frame in section title and change its name to BG and change its properties in the right sidebar. First, I will make sure that its position type is set to absolute, and since we need it to be at the very bottom of the section title frame, I'll make its bottom value 0, and we need it to cover the whole width. I'll make its both left and right spacing 0, and under size I will make its height 48 pixels. Then to change its background to the gradient that we want, I'm going to click fill under the styles and go to the gradients, select the presets and select the last gradient in the presets. Then we need to create the top border of our section title frame. So after selecting it under styles, I'm going to click the box next to border label, and since we only want its border to be at top, I'll make other values 0 and click in the color box. Going back to styles, I'm going to select mid blue from my styles and make the color's opacity 50%. Let's create the section title text. After selecting the text tool, I'll click in section title frame and paste the first feature title that I've generated with ChatGPT, which is task manager, and then while it is selected, I'll change its text style to title. Then under position at right sidebar, I will make its top value 27 and left value 0. We need to start creating our icon component since we're going to use it in multiple places in our section. So I'm going to click the insert button at top left, type material to the search bar and drag the material component into the section title frame, and I'll make sure it is pinned to the right and bottom. Then I will lock its aspect ratio and make its width 180 pixels and color turquoise from the color styles, and I'll change the icon to task and make its style rounded. Now we need to create left and right halves of the icon. To do that, I'm going to first add frame to the icon and name the frame icon. Then I will select the material icon and unlocking its aspect ratio, I'll make its right value minus 180 to make its left half visible. Then I will turn it into a component, leaving the name as icon. In the components screen, I will change variant 1's name to left, since it is going to be the left variant of our icon. Then I'm gonna create a new variant and name it right. And since this is going to be the right half of our icon, in the right variant, I'll select the material layer and under position, I'll make the right value 0, and this time making left value minus 180, I'll create the right half of our icon. Now we need to reduce the icon component's opacity. After selecting its primary variant, I'll make its opacity 0.65, since it would look too vibrant with this color in 100% opacity. Since we have everything we need in our section title frame, we can create the other half of our section. So after going back to home screen, I'm going to duplicate the section title frame rename the clone section content, and I will start changing some of its properties at right sidebar. Under size, I'm going to make its height build, then I'll click layout to turn it into a stack, and under layout I'll change direction to vertical. Align is going to be start, and padding top and left is going to be 40 pixels. Under styles, I'll remove its border. Then I will select both section title and section content elements, and then I'm gonna wrap them in a stack. Which is going to be named sticky wrap. Now I can set the desktop breakpoint's height to its content again, since it became fixed after we created our section content stack. Now we can start changing some properties of our sticky wrap at the right sidebar. Under position, type is going to be sticky. Under size, I'll make sure width is set to fill. Height is going to be viewport height. Under layout, direction is going to be horizontal. Align is going to be start, and gap is going to be 0. And lastly, under styles, we need to make its overflow visible. Time to make changes in section content stack. First, since after turning the layout on, BG frame's position became relative, I'll change it back to absolute and pin it to left, bottom and right, and remove its top pin and make its space to left, right and bottom 0. Then I will delete the section title and paste the section detail text and change some properties of it. Under position, I'll make the type absolute, and the top value is going to be 26, left is going to be 90, and under size, width is going to be 310, and under text, I'll make sure that its style is set to body. I also need to add a top border for the section content, since I need that border to stick to top, becoming the complement of the left border. I can't set it as the border of the content section. I need to create a separate frame as a border. So I'll create a frame inside section content, name it border, and change its properties at right sidebar, making its position absolute, and left and right values are going to be 0, since I want it to be full width, and I'll make its bottom value 244, removing its top pin also. And under size, its height is going to be 1, and under styles, I'll make its fill mid blue from my styles with 50% opacity. Now we can edit the icon's properties in the section content, right? So after selecting it, I'm gonna make its position absolute and make its left and bottom values 0. And lastly, under icon component properties, I'll change its variant to right. Before creating our section component, I'll select the stick wrap stack and wrap it in another stack, which is going to be section. Now we can change some properties of the section stack, right? So under layout, I will change its align to start. Gap is going to be 62 pixels, and I will edit its padding values. Vertically, I need 150 pixels of paddings. And under styles, I'm going to change its fill to dark blue one from my styles, and its overflow is going to be visible for sticky position property to work. We also need to have a second icon in the section content frame, just a copy of it with a lower opacity to show the right half of the icon. So I will duplicate the icon we have there and name the top one icon 1. Then I will change some properties of it. Top spacing value is going to be 62, and I will remove its bottom pin to keep it pinned to left and top. And under styles, I will make its opacity 0.2. Looks like we are ready to create our section component, right? So after selecting it, I'm going to right click and select create component from the dropdown, leaving its name as it is. And in the component screen, I will once again make sure that sticky wrap's height is set to viewport. In the section component screen, since we're going to use the same icon in all parts of our section, we need to assign it to the same variable to change it comfortably. But that variable should be created in the icon component inherited in the section. So I'll double click the icon component to edit it. Then I'll select the material component in the primary variant, and at right sidebar under material component settings, I'll click the name label and click in the create variable. I'll change the variable name to icon name. And since we created our variable in the primary variant, it's going to be applied to also the right variant. Going back to section components screen, I'll select the icon component in the section title frame, and I'll click the icon name labeled under the icon component properties, and click in create variable. I'll leave its name as icon name to assign it to the variable we've created in the icon component. Since we need to be able to change the section's icon with a single variable, we need to assign all icon components' name to the same variable. So I'll select the icon 1 in the section content frame, and again icon component properties in the right sidebar. I'll click the icon name, and hovering over set variables, I'll select the icon name variable. We also need to do the same for the last icon component in the section content. So again, under the icon component properties, set variable, icon name. Now we can create the other variant of our section component with the alternative background color. After selecting the primary variant, I will click the plus button next to it and create a new variant. Under styles in the right sidebar, I'm going to change this background to dark blue too. And we can go back to home screen, duplicate the section component twice, and changing the second one's variant to variant 2. And as you see, can change our icon once to change it in all of the icon component instances. Actually, we can create a go to top button at the very bottom, which is also going to create enough bottom space for us to see the last section's scroll animation, as we've been doing also in some other tutorials, which I'll leave links in the description for. I will drag the material component to it and change some of its properties. After locking its aspect ratio, I will make its width 82 pixels, and under material component properties, change it to chevron left, and rotate it to make it an up icon in the style I want, and change its color to turquoise, and make its style rounded. Now we can change some of the properties of go to top frame, right? After selecting it, I will add a link to top section, home and top, which belongs to the top bar, and I will make also scroll smooth. Under size, width is going to be fill, height is going to be fit content, and under layout, I will change its top and bottom paddings to 120. And under styles, I will click its fill and select the gradient tab. And under presets, I'm going to select second to last. Now I can go to the preview mode and see how icons look on scroll, and how go to top button works. I think it works perfectly. Time to create other section component variables. So I'm gonna go to the section components screen. After selecting the task manager feature title, I'll scroll down to text section and click in the content label. Hovering over create variable, I'll select plain text and leave the variable's name as title. Next, I will select the feature detail text, and again under the text section, click in the content label. I will create a variable, this time it's going to be formatted text, and change its name to detail. Now that we have all the variables we need in our section component, I will go back to home screen and start entering the content that I've created with ChatGPT. Now we can start to create scroll effects, right? So I'm gonna go to the section components screen, and we can start with the simplest one, which is the scroll transform for the border at the section content. After selecting it, I will click effects at the right sidebar, and I'm going to select scroll transform from the dropdown, and as trigger, I'm gonna select section in view. I'm gonna leave the report at the bottom, and since we need section to be unique for each of the section component instance, I will create a variable leaving its name scroll section. Then I will click From, and since we need our border frame to grow as we scroll, I will make both opacity and scale 0. And under 2, I'll make sure opacity and scale 1. Then I will go back to home screen and I'm gonna start entering scroll section values for each of our sections. Clicking the scroll section label at the right hand sidebar. To keep it simple, I'm gonna enter 1 for the first one, 2 for the second, and so on. And lastly, for each section component instance, I will select its scroll section under the section component properties. Now we can test to see if our border animation works for the section content frame. As you see, our border animation works, but what we forgot is changing the border's opacity, right? So I'm gonna go to the section component screen, selecting the border. I will make its color opacity 50%. Now I'm gonna test again. And yeah, its style certainly matches the left part of the border. Next, we're gonna apply the last scroll animation, which is going to be for the icon component at the bottom in the section content. After selecting it, I'm going to again click the effects in the right sidebar and select scroll transform, and as trigger again I will select section in view. Again, since we want trigger scroll section to be unique for each section, I will assign this value also to the scroll section variable that we've created. And for a nice rotating animation, under the from settings, I will make opacity 0, scale 5, and for rotate I'll select 3D, enter 360 for the Y value. And under 2 settings, I'll make sure that opacity and scale is set to 1. Lastly, while the icon component is still selected, under transforms, I will add an origin value and set it both X and Y values to 100 to make the animation better. And going back to home screen, I'm gonna preview our animations. And with a great animation, our icons complete their left house, right? And we can go to top and see our animations again. Hope you liked the tutorial. Be sure to subscribe and turn the notifications on and check my other tutorials. So see you in the next one.